Hey, what's up guys, my name is Sumit and welcome to VisionCG. Recently, I saw Guardians of Galaxy Volume 2 trailer and it was so amazing guys, especially the baby Groot, so cute. Smash the like button for the baby Groot's cuteness. When I saw the trailer, I noticed how they created studio logo intro, retro style I guess. I tried to make same intro using After Effects. Unfortunately, right now I'm stuck with a system that got no graphic card to use Element 3D. So I decided to create fake 3D, which works fine and also it's RAM friendly. Easy to make as well as quick to render. So let's begin. I have already created a project, so let's create a composition. If you want, you can take a look at my previous tutorial where I have explained how I created composition and some basic stuff. Here, let's enter composition name. Let's call it intro. I'm keeping everything same. 1920x1080 resolution at 23.923 frames per second. Almost 24 frames per second. Start code 0 with total duration of 8 seconds. I want my background to be dark but not completely black but close to black, so dark gray it is. Hit OK and composition is created. I'm gonna import VisionCG logo title which I have created in Photoshop and importing PSD as a composition. You can import any PNG logo file or better create a text layer. Import this logo comp into intro comp. I'm gonna rename it. Base logo so that it will be easy when we create multiple comps and adjust the scale value so that it fits in composition. I think this looks good so far. As we saw in the trailer, first we get 3D logo. In order to create 3D logo, you need Element 3D, which will be easy but works only when you have a fine quality graphic card, but not everyone has the same kind of system. And that kind of people end up making online tutorial with cheap voiceover and forever alone life. I need some friends. Basically, what I'm saying is, I'm gonna teach you simple hack by which you can create fake 3D logo. It will appear 3D, but it will be still 2D. This is how I'm gonna do this. First, I'm gonna duplicate my layer. So go to Edit, Duplicate. Top one will be cam facing layer and the bottom one will be extrusion layer. Let's hide the top layer and work on the extrusion layer. I'm gonna pre-comp this comp by moving the base logo comp to new comp, where I'll duplicate the base logo multiple times to create fake 3D effects. Let's call this collection of base logo. Double click on the comp to enter. This is our base logo. So this is how we're gonna create fake 3D of this logo. First, enable 3D for this layer. By enabling this, we can move a layer in Z axis also. Also change the view from active camera to top. I'm gonna duplicate this comp. While selecting this comp, I'm gonna press P on my keyboard. Move this layer behind the original layer by changing the Z axis value from 0 to 1. Repeat this step, duplicate and increase the z-axis value by 1. It's up to you how many layers you want. I think this is enough for decent 3D logo. Our extrusion is ready. Let's go to our intro comp to preview it. You don't see any difference. It's cause the base logo is white and so is our 3D extrusion comp. So change the color to preview it. Go to effects and preset, type fill, drag and drop on the comp to preview. Now you see the extrusion? Good. We are done working with the extrusion. Now for the front facing layer. Let's give it a nice texture and bevel to shine. Create a new layer, call it texture. Put it below our front facing layer. Add color ramp to give it chrome kind of texture. hit the toggle switch in the bottom, select texture layer and change the track matte value to alpha matte. Bring the black and white color close to the logo. Swap the color. White should be on the top. Duplicate the effect. Change black color to dark gray. And change the y-axis value to get better result. If you want to add more detail to your logo, you can either use a metal texture image or you can use noise texture from preset. You can choose various fractal type, but for this tutorial we need subscale with complexity value 4. Change contrast value to 50 and brightness to 20. It's time to add some bevel edge effect to our logo. Just duplicate the base layer. Enable it. Change the blending mode to add. Use fill to change the color. Change the color to black. Now the layer is not visible. Ta-da! But wait, add bevel effect. Increase edge thickness to 10. Now you can see the bevel effect. Change the light angle to 0 so that light will come from the top. I think edge thickness is too much. Let's see. Now it's looking good. Change the light intensity value to something. Okay, this is perfect. Let's duplicate the bevel comp and change its light angle to 180 and lower the intensity. Decrease edge thickness. Enable extrusion comb and change its fill color to something mid-gray. Okay, we are done with our 3D logo. Select all, go to edit, pre-comb. Move all the layer to new comb, call it 3D logo. Ta-da! Congratulations, you got your fake 3D logo. Oh, sorry. I forgot to take a copy of my logo. Copy. Paste. Done. Change the blending mode to normal and remove all the effect. Let's see the trailer. First 3D logo comes and after a few seconds it is converted from 3D to 2D. Okay, let's go to 2 seconds. Select a normal logo, add a fade in transition, hit T on the keyboard to bring the opacity value, set key, use shift page to jump 10 frames, change the opacity value to 0. Now animate the logo to move towards camera. Enable 3D for this layer and set the Z axis value using shift page down 4 times. In short, moving 40 frames, change the z-axis value to negative 2000 to bring it towards camera. Also, we want to make sure that the layer fades out as soon as it's moved toward the camera. So change the opacity value too. Once you are done with all the keyframes, then select all the keyframes, convert to easy ease for smooth transition. Rename the layer to color 1. Move your marker to the keyframe where your logo layer fades in to 100. Move 5 frames using page down. Now duplicate the layer and slide 5 frames to right. Repeat this step again. Just apply fill to all the three layers with all the different vibrant colors you want. Okay, now all you have to do is smooth transition from 3D to 2D. Wait, I forgot to blend gradient ramp with noise effect. Just change some opacity and blending mode. Done. There comes a time like this when I start my tutorial with level 10 and I forgot many stuff and it goes to negative 10 instantly, rapidly. Go to frame where the first color layer appears. Select 3D logo layer and hit T on the keyboard. Create a fade out effect with easy ease. I think this is a bit fast. Just move the color layers so that 3D layer will fade to 2D layer, stay for a few frames and then continue to the rest of the animation. For position, add a keyframe, go frame 0 and change the z-axis value to negative 500. At the same time, create a fade-in effect. Create a solid layer for the cinematic frame size. Enable proportion grid and follow. For background, create a new solid layer, call it BG, background, and keep it below all the layer. Change the shape to radiant ramp, and change the top color to dark red. Create a fade in and fade out effect for this also. Quick info for those who are new to After Effects and wondering why the hell this guy took the logo and kept it in separate comp and used that comp everywhere instead of using the logo directly. Let me explain. Consider you made everything and after a few hours you think I should change my title or logo, whatever. What you're gonna do, you're gonna go and create all the effects again. But with this method, all you have to do, just go to your base logo comp, hide all the layers that are active, add a new logo or text, and done. That's all you need. It will be updated everywhere. Everything is done. You need to render out the scene so that it can be played as a video and you can share it, because right now it's in a format that can be opened only with After Effects. You need to render out with a format like MP4 or AVI or MOV, whatever that you can play with any player. Okay, stay in your main comp, go to composition, add to render queue. Select QuickTime format. This encoder will help you to render out the high quality video with low size. Select where you want to save your output and hit render. Phew, this tutorial took longer than I expected, but I hope this tutorial was useful for you all. You can show me your artwork on Twitter @TimusEffects, that will be great. Link is in the description. I'm uploading more tutorials as soon as possible, but you can stay updated. All you have to do is be a subscriber on my channel, press the bell icon, accept the terms, hit OK, so that you will be notified instantly as soon as I upload a new video. Keep liking my video, share and comment. It means a lot to me. So see you next time. Till then, stay awesome.